Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, make sure you pop a little comment down below for me and say hi, and remember to subscribe for me as well. Anyway, today we're going to be making a little motif of a bunny because it's obviously Easter coming up and I've got lots of lovely blanket patterns, and I thought a little motif for those blankets might be fantastic for you guys. So I'm going to be using the Aran yarn by Hobby, and it's in the shade number 2. So that's what I'm going to be using for the tail. For the t-shirt part of the bunny, I'm going to be using this lovely pink colour from Yarnsmith. I'm also going to be using this from Hobby, and it's the Mega XL Aran yarn, and it's in the colour 5. We also need a 5mm hook, and let's get started. So this is the little bunny that we're going to be making today, and she is so cute. You can make it in any colours you'd like. It doesn't have to be these colours exactly, but I've chosen these colours as it's for my daughter for her little Easter bonnet. So they can be used for lots of different things. So Easter bonnets, blankets, t-shirts, pretty much anything you want. It's just a little motif. And this is the back. So you can glue them on, you can sew them on, it's up to you. So let's get into the tutorial. Okay guys, so for this tutorial I am going to be using Aran yarn, however I have got the written tutorial and that one uses double knit. So the only difference really between the written pattern and this tutorial is just the size of the yarn, and the only difference that will give you is how big the actual bunny comes out. So you can do it in double knit using a 4mm hook, or you can do it in Aran using a 5mm hook, but it's completely up to you. And of course I will link the pattern down below for you as well. So we're going to start off by making a magic ring. So I'm going to wrap it around my finger 2 times. I'm going to slide underneath those 2 on my finger, and I'm going to grab the working yarn and bring that through. Then slide it off my finger, chain up 1, and that's your magic ring made. So I'm actually going to be doing double crochets into this ring, so I'm going to chain up another 1. So we've got 2 chains, and that's not going to count as our first double crochet. We're then going to put 14 double crochets into the ring. So to do a double crochet, you're going to yarn over your hook, go into the ring, yarn over your hook again, and bring up a loop. We've got 3 loops on the hook, and we're going to go through 2. So we've yarned over, go through 2, yarn over, and go through 2. So I'll do that one more time for you. We're going to yarn over our hook, go into the loop, yarn over, pull up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, go through 2 of those loops on your hook, then yarn over and go through the other 2 loops on your hook. And you're going to do that a total of 14 times. So I've got 2 here as well as the chain 2, but the chain 2 does not count as our first stitch. So I've now got my 14 double crochets into my ring, and I'm going to start tightening up this loop. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull these 2 apart a little bit so we can see them separately. And then we're going to pull on the little tail end here until we see one of these 2 tighten. So I'm going to pull, and I can see that it's the one here at the back that started to move. So I'm going to pull that one from the bottom up until that tightens my ring. As you can see, it's starting to tighten it there. Just keep pulling until it becomes really nice and tight. And then you're going to pull the tail end, and that'll tighten it completely. And that way it's not going anywhere. And we're going to slip stitch to the top of the first double crochet that we made. Not the top of the chain 2, but the first double crochet. And so the easiest way to find out how many we've done and which one you're meant to be going into is to count backwards. So we're counting the V's on the top all the way back. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we're going to be going into here. And then we're just going to slip stitch. Then we're going to chain up 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I'm going to start working down this chain for the ears. So we're going to go into the second loop from the hook, so this one here, and we're going to do a single crochet. So we're going to go into that chain, yarn over, bring up a loop, yarn over, and go through 2. I'm going to put another single crochet in the next chain. Then we're going to put a half double crochet in each of the next 2 chains. So yarn over into our chain, yarn over, pull up, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all 3. Then we've got 1 chain left, and we're going to put a double crochet into there. Skip a stitch and we're going to slip stitch into the next. We're then going to repeat that again. So we're going to chain up 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And just like before, we're going to start in the second chain from the hook, and we're going to put 1 single crochet in each of the first 2, 1 half double crochet in each of the next 2 after that, and then 1 double crochet in the last chain. We're then going to skip a stitch and slip stitch into the next. And as you can see, our little bunny head's starting to come together. We're going to slip stitch into the next 3. So slip stitch, you just go in, yarn over, pull through, and slip through the loop on your hook. And again. And then one more time. Then we're going to put a single crochet in each of the next 2 stitches. Then in the next, we're going to put 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2. And then again in the next one, 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2. Then we're going to put a single crochet in the next, and we're going to slip stitch to the last stitch. Then we're going to chain 1 and fasten off. Okay, so this is what I've got so far. It's just the little head of our bunny. And now we're going to start making the body. So I'm going to switch to the pink yarn. You can use any color yarn you'd like for this. If you use blue, it does look a little bit like a Peter Rabbit as well, which is kind of cute. So we're going to turn our head upside down, and we're going to work into these 3 slip stitches that we made on our last round. So I'm just going to pop my yarn on my hook by doing a slip knot and popping that on there. We're then going to work into these slip stitches. So I'm just going to pop my hook in here into the slip stitch, and I'm going to slip stitch that on just like so. I'm then going to do a standing double crochet. So I'm going to pull up my yarn, and I'm going to twist around my yarn while holding it still on my hook. I'm going to go into that same space, and I'm going to yarn over, pull up a loop, keeping my finger on there at all times, yarn over and pull through 2, then yarn over and pull through 2. I'm then going to put another double crochet into the same space, so into here. I'm going to pop the tail end over my stitches so I can work over them. And then we're going to put 2 double crochets in the next stitch and 2 double crochets in the next. So we'll have a total of 6 double crochets. Then going to chain 1, and we're going to turn our work so the back is facing us. And we're going to put 2 half double crochets into the first stitch, because the chain 1 does not count as our first stitch. So 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2. Then we're going to put 1 double crochet in each of the next 5 stitches. So for the next row, we're going to do a standing double crochet. So we're going to turn our work, pull up a loop, hold on to that loop with this finger, and we're going to twist around. Then we're going to go into the stitch, yarn over, bring up a loop, making sure you keep your finger on that yarn the whole time on the hook, yarn over, pull through 2, then yarn over, pull through 2. We're going to go back down into the same space, and we're going to put another double crochet. Then we're going to put 1 double crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. We're then going going to chain one and turn our work, and the chain one does not count as our first stitch. So we're going to go back down into the same space and put a single crochet. Then we're going to put a half double crochet in each of the next five stitches. Then you're just going to fasten off. Now we're going to be working back with the brown again. So we're going to make a slip knot with the brown and pop our hook in. Of course, you can use any colours you'd like for your bunny. It doesn't have to be these colours. So we're going to turn it upside down, and starting in the right hand corner, we're going to attach our yarn with a slip stitch. I'm going to flip that little tail end over so that we're working over the top of it and it's already weaved in for us. I'm then going to chain one. I'm then going to put a single crochet into the same space as our chain one. And I'm going to put one half double crochet in each of the next four stitches. And then the last stitch here, we're going to put two half double crochets. And then going to slip stitch to the bottom of that same stitch, chain one and fasten off. And there is our little feet for our bunny. Then going to start working on the little hands. I'm going to attach my yarn again to my hook with a slip knot. And I'm going to start on the inside corner of our hands and attach our yarn with a slip stitch. Then going to fold that little tail end over, so we're working over it, and chain one. And I'm going to put two half double crochets into the first stitch, one and two. And then one half double crochet into the next. I'm then going to slip stitch to the bottom of that stitch to secure and then fasten off. I'm just going to go back through and weave in all my ends. So you can either glue this onto a project or you can sew it on. If you're going to sew it on, I'd recommend using some thread rather than yarn, just because it's a bit easier to use, and also a clear thread would be great as well, so you don't see any of the stitches. We're just going to pop a little tail on. I'll show you how to do that now. So for the bunny tail, we're going to wrap the yarn around our finger and we're going to make a magic ring. So slide my hook underneath those two and pull through the working yarn. I'm then going to chain one, and into that magic ring I'm going to put six single crochets. Then I'm going to tighten up that ring. And I'm just going to slip stitch to the first single crochet that we made, so that's this one here. And then going to chain one and fasten off, and then I'm going to weave in that little tail end there, and then you can sew it onto your bunny, onto the little bum. And that is your cute little Easter bunny made. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, guys. If you have, be sure to subscribe, like and comment for me, and share it with all your friends, and I hope you have a wonderful Easter. I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.